وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول
الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد Inshallah ta'ala, in this episode, I'm going to be speaking about مظاهر دنو الهمة. I'm going to give some ways, some forms in which low aspiration enters. Things in which low aspiration is found in. دنو الهمة, low aspiration, يأخذ مظاهر عدة. It goes into many forms in our life. The first one, inshallah ta'ala, that I want to mention here is دُنُوُّ الْهِمَّ فِي طَلَبِ الْعِلْمِ. Having low aspiration when it comes to seeking knowledge. And it happens in five ways. Having low aspiration when it comes to seeking knowledge, it occurs in five ways. The first is مَنْ لَا يَطْلُبُ الْعِلْمَ أَصْلًا. A person who doesn't seek knowledge at all. He will not go forward in seeking knowledge. He does not exert the effort to learning the necessary knowledge that he or she should know. He's happy to be ignorant. He doesn't want to exert what is needed from them in gaining knowledge. مع قدرتي على اكتسابه وتحصيله, even though he's able to seek knowledge. Even though he has the physical and the mental ability, he doesn't want to seek it. That's دُنُوُّ الْهِمَّ فِي طَلَبِ الْعِلْمِ. That's the first form. The second form is مَنْ يَطْلُبُ الْعِلْمِ. A person who will seek knowledge. وَيَجِدُّ فِي تَحْصِيلِ. And he will exert the effort in seeking knowledge. Because he knows the value of knowledge. The second way in which low aspiration occurs is مَنْ يَطْلُبُ الْعِلْمِ. A person who will seek knowledge. وَيَجِدُّ فِي تَحْصِيلِ. And he will exert the efforts required in seeking knowledge. لَا لِإِدْرَاكِ فَضِيلَتِهِ. And it is not because that this person understands the virtue of knowledge. And they are not doing it to raise ignorance from themselves. Or to purify themselves. Or to spread that knowledge. No. Their highest aspiration here is to attain that certificate. And to get that job after it. Oh, when I get that certificate, I'm going to be the imam of that big masjid in my local area. Allahu Akbar. I've always wanted that. All he sees seeking knowledge is that certificate. It will guarantee me a job and I'm going to live a life of happiness. And that is what many people are. Even if you look at the academic sciences that they learn, they'll learn medicine and whatnot, and they do it for money. So I can get money, a good job. They don't do it because they want to help the ummah. They don't have that aspiration. Very low aspiration. The third is a person who seeks knowledge. But his reason is, he can be higher than his friends and his colleagues. وَيُمَارِي السُّفَهَا. He wants to put down the ignorant ones and say, yeah, you don't know anything. When are you going to start studying? Exactly, I'm better than you. He wants to. وَيُبَهِي الْعُلَمَا. He wants to point out the scholars and put the scholars in difficult situations and ask them difficult questions. And وَيَصْرِفَ وُجُوهَ النَّاسِ إِلَيْهِ. He wants to turn the people to him. He wants to be the focus. Al-Allama Muhammad Al-Khidr Al-Husayn rahimahullah, he said something very powerful. He said, لَمْ يَقْضِ حَقَّ الْعِلْمِ بَلْ لَمْ يَدْرِ شَرَفَ الْعِلْمِ بَلْ لَمْ يَدْرِ شَرَفُ الْعِلْمِ ذَلِكَ الَّذِي يَطْلُبُهُ لِيَنَالَ بِهِ رِزْقًا أَوْ يُنَافِسَ فِيهِ قَرِينًا حَتَّى إِذَا أَدْرَكَ وَظِيفَةً أَوْ أنس من نفسه الفوز على القرين أمسك عنانه ثانية وتحنى عن الطلب جانبا وإنما ترفع الأوطان رأسها وتبرز في مظاهر عزتها بهمم أولئك الذين يقبلون على العلم بجد وثبات ولا ينقطعون عنه إلا أن ينقطعوا عن الحياة. He says, rahimahullah, they have not given knowledge. He says, لم يقضي حق العلم. They have not fulfilled the rights of knowledge. And they haven't understood the honor of knowledge. Which people? The one who is seeking knowledge for rizq. What am I going to eat? What am I going to drink? Or he's learning it so he can compete with others and belittle the people and put the scholars in a situation and show the people that he knows better than the scholars. Those people haven't understood the honor of knowledge. The fourth way in which low aspiration in knowledge occurs is بعض المتسبين للعلم, a group of people who attribute themselves to knowledge. فما إن يشدو في العلم, as soon as they become, you know, grounded maybe in some sciences, or they might learn some issues related to the religion, or they might gain some knowledge here or there. ويكتسب قليلا منه إلا ويتطاول على مقام الراسقين في العلم. He opens his tongue straight away to the people of knowledge. يعني he understood a مسألة here or there, and he maybe studied a chapter or two of knowledge, and then he now goes out and he critiques the scholars, those who are grounded, who are older and more senior and more great, noble than him. He opens his tongue at them, insults them, belittles them. This is a sign of low aspiration as well. ولذلك the poet, he said, وَابْنُ اللَّبُونِ إِذَا مَا لُزَّ فِي قَرَنٍ لَمْ يَسْتَطِعْ صَوْلَةَ الْبُزْلِ الْقَنَاعِيسِ. This line of poetry, what it means is that وَابْنُ اللَّبُونِ, Ibn al-Labun is the camel that's 2 years of age, he completed 2 years of age, is now moving on to the third year, and they called it Ibn al-Labun is because the mother, when she gave birth to it, the camel gave birth to this child, she abandoned it in breastfeeding. She had another child that she was breastfeeding with it, and so she gave milk to that other camel. So Ibn al-Labun is a male that's finished 2 years and moving on to the third year. In the zakat, the person, he doesn't give the Ibn al-Labun unless he has, first he has to give Bintu Makhad. The Bintu Makhad goes first. If you don't have it, then okay, Ibn al-Labun is accepted from you. He's saying, the poet here is saying, وَابْنُ اللَّبُونِ إِذَا مَا لُزَّ فِي قَرَنٍ لَمْ يَسْتَطِعْ صَوْلَةَ الْبُزْلِ الْقَنَاعِيسِ. And the camel that's 3 years, and he's 2 years and now going to the third year, can it really come into a challenge and fight with بُزْلِ الْقَنَاعِيسِ الْبَازِلُ الْقَاعِسِ? It can't. The بُزْلِ الْقَنَاعِيسِ is the camel that's 8 years. And again, that's قَنَاعِيسِ meaning شَدِيد, which is قَوِي. Can it really go at it? No. So the poet here, which is Jarir, he's saying that I am here, the بُزْلِ الْقَنَاعِيسِ, and the other people are وَابْنُ الْلَبُونِ. So today, a lot of students are just وَابْنُ الْلَبُونِ. They are وَابْنُ الْلَبُونِ compared to the scholars who are the poet, his statement here, which is the بُزْلِ الْقَنَاعِيسِ. Scholar is senior than you, more knowledgeable, they're more grounded than you. And also another poet, he said, إِذَا تَلَاقَ الْفُيُولُ وَازْدَحَمَتْ فَكَيْفَ حَالُ الْبَعُوضِ فِي الْوَسَطِ. And what would a fly and a mosquito be in a situation where يعني, big animals are headbutting and they get destroyed, right? Sometimes you find a student of knowledge, he will get into the discussion of great scholars talking, and it's not open for you. If you come, it will crush you. It's low aspiration. The one who has high aspiration, brothers and sisters, seeking knowledge, his aim and objective in life is أن يكون النفع بعلمه أشمل. His goal is to benefit others. That is what he wants. And he also wants to respect the scholars. And when I say respect the scholars, I don't mean that you just take everything that they say. وَلَا يَعْنِي إِحْتَرَامُهَا أَخْذُهَا بِالْقَبُولِ وَالتَّسْلِيمِ عَلَى أَيِّ حَالِ. That whatever the scholar says, take it without questioning him. No, what we mean is look in the evidences, look at the statements, observe, research, without a doubt. But respect the scholar for his ijtihad that he's reached. And he says, alim, he got it right or wrong. And if the Prophet said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that the scholars are either between one or two rewards, how are you here to shame him and name call him? You see? And what we have to also understand, brothers and sisters, is that al-fitr salima, the pure fitrah, wal-nufus zakiyah, and the honorable souls will never ever result to those type of actions. To speak about a person of ilm in a very despicable way. And what we have to understand is that people will never accept what you say if you're opening your tongue to the people of knowledge. And it's a sign of low aspiration that all you want to become known for is that you open your tongue on the people of knowledge. That you open your tongue on the people of knowledge. ولذلك the poet, he said, لَا تَضَعْ مِنْ عَظِيمٍ قَدْرٍ وَإِنْ كُنْ تَمُشَارًا إِلَيْهِ بِالتَّعْظِيمِ فَالْكَبِيرُ الْعَظِيمُ يَصْغُرُ قَدْرًا بِالتَّجَرِّي عَلَى الْكَبِيرِ الْعَظِيمِ. And don't ever put a person who's high in the eyes of the people, don't try to put them low. Because the truth of the matter really is that you're the one that's going to drop. You're the one that's going to drop. Not the person who is you're saying something about. The fifth and final point in regards to having low aspiration in seeking knowledge is that which takes place between the students. من تحاسد وتغاير وتنافس غير شريف. The enmity and the grudges and the feelings that happen between students of knowledge. Knowledge really is meant to be the thing that brings about light, brings about harmony, brings about good. It's not what brings about hate and grudge and enmity. The poet said, "Al-ilmu lil-rajul al-labib ziyadatun wa naqisatun lil-ahmaq al-tayyashi mithlu an-nahari yazidu absar al-wara nuran wa yu'shi a'yun al-khuffashi." The poet said, "Al-ilmu, knowledge, لِلْرَجُلِ اللَّبِيبِ, knowledge is to the one who is smart, a good thing. The smart person, knowledge brings good for them. It pushes them to that which is good. It benefits them. Like in the أحمق, the dim-witted one, a طَيَّاش, that jumps on everything, knowledge is actually destruction for him. When knowledge comes to him, he becomes arrogant and he starts to insult everybody and وَمَا إِلَى ذَلِكَ. Inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to stop there for this episode. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and Shaytan. And Allah and His Messenger are both free from it. Subhanaka Allahumma bihamdi. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. How can you do a 2-second action right now that will give you a share of the reward of everything we're doing on this YouTube channel? Simple. Like this video and click subscribe. Why? It will allow YouTube to recommend our videos to other users. And imagine the huge amount of reward that could be waiting for you on the Day of Judgment if you did that with a sincere intention of spreading the Deen of Allah. You'll be rewarded for every single person who benefits from one of our videos as a result of your like or subscribe. That's an easy 2-second action that you definitely don't want to miss out on. Do it now, click like, and subscribe, and don't forget to make that intention.